Everyone, a
Malika,
very
can you
pleasant
please
morning
move away?
to everyone. Okay, ma'am. Hello, everyone. A very pleasant morning to everyone. I'm Sonali Sharma.
I think we need to switch
that
off our mics.
Malika, you will need to please. We can't hear you. Please switch your mic.
Everyone. Ma'am, no, am I audible?
Hello, Sonali.
Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes, go ahead.
Okay, ma'am. I am a welcome. On the occasion of Shrimati Shanti Gupta Center for Women Studies event, meet the eminent women personality. I would request Dr. Rita Dwivedi, Assistant Professor, My College of Education, for formal welcome to the gathering.
Thank you, Sonali. Good morning to all of you. First of all, I would like to express my gratitude to each one of you for attending this event. A very warm welcome to everyone on this web platform. On the behalf of Srimati Shanti Gupta Center for Women Studies, I am proud and privileged to greet our distinguished resource person, Dr. Chand Trehan, Registered Counselor, Rehabilitation Council of India. Thank you so much, ma'am, for accepting our invitation and coming over for the webinar. I am convinced that your knowledge, experience, and expertise will contribute significantly to the improvement of national framework for promoting gender equality and women's empowerment. On behalf of the center, I offer my regards and extend a warm welcome to Dr. Renu Gupta, our worthy chairperson, Meyer Group of Institutions, for sparing her valuable time and gracing the event. We are honored to have you with us, ma'am. It gives me immense pleasure to extend a hearty welcome to Dr. Adit Gupta, esteemed director and principal, Meyer College of Education, for sparing his valuable time for us. Sir, you have motivated us all enough by being an example of light in the darkness. I bid a very warm welcome to Mrs. Rupa Gupta, Joint Director, Meyer, and Director, Center for Women Studies, Mrs. Ruchika Gupta, Joint Director, MIT, who have taken time out of their busy schedule and joined us today to be a part of this event. I feel delighted to welcome Dr. Moolraj Sharma, HOD, PG Department, Dr. Ronika Sharma, HOD, UG Department, Dr. Nisha Rana, and Dr. Monica Bajaj, Deputy HODs of PG and UG departments, for their gracious presence. We are privileged to have in attendance the esteemed faculty members and dear students of both the departments. I welcome you all once again. I hope we have an engaging and enriching session ahead. Thank you so much.
I request for Miss Sadhguru today.
Sonali, you please switch off your video, then we can hear you. Yes, please start again. Switch off your video and then.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Switch off your video.
Just on your microphone.
Thank you, ma'am. Now, I would request Director Center for Women's Studies, Mrs. Rupa Gupta, to formally introduce the resource person of today's event.
Thank you, Sonali. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Center for Women's Studies event, Meet the Eminent Women Personality. Before I introduce the resource person of today's session, I would like you to take a moment and use your imagination. Imagine if you are living a life without any rights, without any protection. All inequalities are snatched, or equalities snatched away from you, and have to face discrimination at every step. People challenging your very existence. It's hard for us to imagine all these scenarios. But some women stand out because they fight and manage to step forward and make a difference, despite the dangers they would face. This is what our resource person will share with us today: challenging gender inequalities, role of teachers, school, and society. I have the great pleasure of introducing Dr. Chand Trehan, a prominent freelance psychologist with PhD in psychology from Punjab University, Patiala, who has been working in the field of counseling since last 29 years. She is also the founder director of CARE North, Center for Counseling, Assessment, Research, and Empowerment. Besides being on the panel of CBSE as a resource person and telehelpline counselor, she is an innovative educator and a successful psychological consultant. She is a much sought-after speaker and trainer in North India for parental sessions, teachers' workshops, and individual and group counseling for students and destitute women. She inspires and encourages people to realize their true potential. She has traveled across length and breadth of country, conducting numerous sessions and workshops for adolescents and youth. Her 29 years of research and understanding has put younger generations and organizations on path of growth and fulfillment. In brief, I would say that she is a master trainer for Global Fund to Fight Against AIDS, Tuberculosis, and Malaria, CBSE Master Trainer for Adolescent Education Program and Comprehensive Health Program, and one of the 97 selected telecounselors for the CBSE helpline at the national level, and Aao Baat Kare in Jammu and Kashmir. She is approved counselor for Army Welfare Education Society, senior consultant JNK for DAV Sangathan Schools, mentor for kindergarten schools. Ma'am has been awarded with Acharya Chanakya Shikshava Samman in 2020. She was honored with Dr. Sri Radha Krishnan Award at the Educators Commendation Ceremony on 5th September 2020. And Director of School Education also awarded her for Telecounseling Helpline Initiative, Aao Baat Kare, during COVID times, attending calls related to mental health, stress, career guidance, academics, and child protection. She helps in building a positive personality on a solid foundation based on values and ethics. Ma'am, it's an honor to have you with us today, and we will look forward to your session. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Chand Trehan. Ma'am, please, we are waiting for you to start your session. Thank you.
Respected Renu ma'am, the director, principal, all the stars of Mayur, and the lovely, beautiful students. A very good morning to each one of you. I'm indeed very honored and very happy to be here today, because sitting in Chandigarh, I am in Jammu, with just because you are there with me on this platform. So I am today actually very happy and feeling very much at home. You know, we are always talking about gender equality, and we are talking about women empowerment. A lot of things come to our mind. What exactly are we meaning by all this? So today I've created a little presentation for you all. And in fact, since day before yesterday when you told me to come and talk about it, I actually started giving it a serious thought. Because till now we were, you know, listening to other people fighting for their rights and talking about gender equality. And it's just a passing story going on. So I thought it was a time to stop a while and actually understand what is gender. So the first thing which came to my mind was the form which we used to fill for the railway ticket long, long time back. Uske corner mein, right side mein likha hota tha gender, male or female. I'm sure aap logon ko bhi, aap bhi recollect kar rahe hoge. So that's where the first something went wrong. Because gender is not male and female. That is sex, male or female. So, you know, it gave me a deep thought, and I'm very fortunate that I was in a project by Geneva. This was a global fund to fight against AIDS, tuberculosis and malaria, where we were training counselors across the country. And the first time somebody tried to show us the difference between gender and sex, and that was a time way back, I think about 11 years back or so, that I actually started thinking that somewhere down the line we are going wrong. Because we are all following that old traditional way of understanding. Today, I can see a lot of learned people here and people with a lot of experience. But we also have students who are now going to the schools. So today, my talk is going to be more focused for the students because I want them to be the torch bearers. I want them to go with a clear idea when they are approaching a school for a job or to act as a teacher or a principal. So I'll request you to allow me to share the presentation. Is it allowed?
Yes, ma'am. You can share.
Can you all see it?
Yes, ma'am.
Because at times, you know, at these meets, people tell me that the slide gets stuck. So whenever there's a problem, because I can't see you now, I can just see my own screen. So do let me know if I get stuck somewhere. So the topic is so, so interesting. It's challenging gender inequalities, role of a teachers, school and society. Now, this is what we usually see around us. If you look at these little covers of these packets, just see how gender bias are there. Girls are supposed to be playing with only dolls and boys with cars. Boys are clever. Girls are gorgeous. Women don't leave kitchen. So all this, and when we are talking about gender equality, we have to keep in mind this as well. These are the modern advertising. So I'm just showing you the slides which you are very self-explanatory. And this is the conversation. How to change conversation? The Google says women should stay at home and things like that. Now, these facts and images have all been taken from developed westernized countries. And there are strategies which are working on it now. Many countries in Asia-Pacific region have already achieved or close to achieving gender parity. However, it does not mean that there is no gender issue in education. Because actually I would say when the gender issue is in education, actually the gender issue is very much starting from our own homes where the roles are already assigned to the children. If you look at the statistics, are we equal? The workplace, women earn less 10% for full-time and 34% for part-time. 70% of the minimum wage jobs are done by women. 55% of women take part in labor market. The only area where you can see a little bit of gender equality is the body image, because men also feel bad when they are not looking very good. And again, you can see 20% of the men are extremely concerned about their weight, leading to depression or other misuse of drugs. Boys have trucks, girls have dolls. And if I remember my childhood, I too was gifted a doll and my brother was gifted a truck. So boys can eat the way they want to, but girls have to cook. And today also in most of the households and everywhere, you will see that this thing is still so predominant that the mothers are insisting that the girls should come in the kitchen to help and the boys are there to either do the outside work or to be at home making merry. So these are little slides which I thought will make things very, very clear for you. So sex is what you're born with and gender is what you're given. This is what I was wanting to say when I started in the beginning. That is what was a learning for me also. So what is gender? The difference between...
I'm changing the slides because we can't see the changing of the slides.
Yes, yes, that's what I'm...
We are on the first one still?
Yes, ma'am.
So why is this happening?
Can you share with me your slides?
Can you see the changing?
No, ma'am.
Rajanji, have you already, has she sent her slides to you,
presentation?
I can do that just now if you want.
That's
yes,
maybe just try it once more.
Okay.
Now can you see?
Yes, ma'am.
The slide is how to change the conversation.
I've changed four of them.
Okay. So we are on slide 5, how to change the conversation. We are on slide 5.
Yeah, how to, very good. So now just let me know. Can you see the sixth one?
No, ma'am. Still on 5th.
There is something happening. Is it the network issue or...
Ma'am, you just click on 6th slide, then we will be able to see it. You just click on 6th slide on the left side of your screen.
Okay, so I'll go slide by slide, that's what you mean?
Yes, ma'am, yes. On 6th, if you click now, on 6th. Yes.
Now you can see?
Yes,
yes, ma'am.
So I'll go like this then. I think it's a network issue which is not letting us do it properly.
Just excuse me, can we blow them up so that we can see the full screen?
Now is it all right?
If it can be blown further, maybe we'd be having a full screen. Maybe Rajanji can...
Ma'am, there is in the bottom, there is this button. Like
slideshow.
Yeah. Pardon? So if I do the entire thing...
So it should come in the full screen. That is what we want so that everybody can see.
Yeah, moment I'm doing it in the full screen, ma'am, this is the slides are not moving.
Ma'am, can you send me your PPT?
If for the PPT, then he can probably do it that for you. So you can maybe focus on the content that would might be.
So what I can do, I'll just send it to you in a minute.
Yeah.
Can you send me the email address just now?
Yes, ma'am.
Rajan, just type it in... chat box, right?
Okay. I'm so sorry for this hiccup at all. I should have sent it to you earlier.
No, that's okay. No problems.
Ma'am, I was waiting. You told me that you are sending.
I told you yesterday.
Yeah. I was waiting.
Vadim Salapi at Maya College, Boston.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Is there a space there, Rajanji?
No, ma'am. Rajan.Salathi@myercollege.in.
It is continuous?
Yes, ma'am.
Please check, Rajanji. So tell, have you got it?
No, ma'am. Ma'am, can you send to the Rupa ma'am? The Rupa ma'am just sent with me, with me from WhatsApp.
Rajan ji, aapko bhej diya?
Ma'am, abhi to nahi aaya, ma'am.
हाँ जी मूलराज जी, यू आर एक्सपेक्टेड टू टेक द लीड इन दिस एंड मेक इट हैपन.
मैम, टिल ही रिसीव योर फाइल यू कैन जस्ट शेयर इट एंड देन आई लेट यू नो हाउ टू डू इट.
आपको इट इज आर ए जे एन एस एल ए टी एच आई ए.
जस्ट कॉपी इट एंड पेस्ट मैम, जस्ट कॉपी इट एंड देन पेस्ट इन टू.
Actually, ma'am, you have missed a dot in between.
Just, I'll just do that. Where is he? I think in the chat it's got lost. Where is it? इन्होंने dot डाला है ना राजन जी ने?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
हमने डालना है dot के नहीं?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so that's the problem. Yeah. अब देखिए राजन जी मिल गया.
नो मैम, अभी नहीं आया.
हाँ जी,
अभी नहीं आया मैम यहाँ पे.
कोई अल्टरनेट मेरे को दे दीजिए नंबर.
मैम व्हाट्सएप कर सकते हो आप रूपा मैम को, तो रूपा मैम सेंड कर देंगी व्हाट्सएप पे मुझे.
नहीं, आई हैव इट ऑन माय डेस्कटॉप, सो समबडी एल्सस नंबर इफ आई कैन गेट.
रीता द्विवेदी मैम, हैव यू गिवन एनी काइंड ऑफ ईमेल टू मैम अर्लियर? So that
anybody else who can forward it to Rajanji if it's not coming to him.
Ma'am, you can leave rohanika.sharma@myercollege.in otherwise.
Can you just spell it out? I'm just doing it.
Yes, ma'am. R-O-H-N-I-K-A.
R-O-H. Yeah.
N-I-K-A.
N-I-K-E.
N-I-K-A.
Okay.
Rohanika.sharma.
Okay. @myercollege.in.
Not yet, ma'am. I'm opening my inbox only, but I have not received.
Excuse me, ma'am. What is your email ID?
DrChandrehan@gmail.com. Yeah, that'll be nice. I can reply to you then.
Okay. Okay. It is in continuity,
ma'am. I'll forward it to Rajan sir.
Achha, good, good. Yeah, I can continue and you can just
I will just forward it. Just give me a minute.
And we can continue in the meanwhile.
Yeah.
Okay. So till they so I'll set it up. I'll do it with the window thing.
Yeah. Rajan sir, please check now.
Okay, ma'am.
So can some can you all see this? So like we were talking, can you all see?
Yes, we are on slide 7 now.
Okay, good. So when we were talking about the statistics, we had said that women, like you can see, that they are earning less or they are more in the labor market, And the only place where they found gender equality was the body image, where the men were feeling equally bad if their body image was not very good. Now in the education field, 20% of girls are put off science because it's for boys, and 90% nurses are females, whereas men earn 5% more even as a nurse. So there is so much of disparity that time has come, or is already, people are getting aware that we have to somewhere start working on gender equality. Now, like these are again some images that are so clearly showing you.
Ma'am, shall I share, ma'am?
Are you switching it?
Yes, ma'am. I'll stop presenting.
Okay. We can carry on. The next one, please. We talked about gender equality, and we've already talked about the Asia Pacific region has achieved quite a lot of gender parity, but yet a lot of work has to be done. And the base is the parents and the education system and the society at the end of it. Next, please. So this we have already done. We're talking about the workplace inequality and the education setup inequality, and these slides we have already gone through, so we can go ahead. Yeah, this one also we have done about the body image we were talking. Next, please. So these are again the pictures which are enforcing what we were talking. Next, please. Next, please. So sex is what you are born with. Gender is the previous one, please, is what you are given. So this is something which brings a lot of clarity in now understanding, because believe me, when we were told to do an exercise and activity on this part, most of us, you know, when they gave us a form, gender kya hai, so we wrote male or female. And but even now, as of now, a lot of people do that, but we have to be clear about this, that sex is what you're born with. That means if you're a boy or a girl, you're born with that, you can't change much about it. But yes, the gender, that is the role you are assigned to do, is in the hands of the people, the society, the education system. Next, please. So what is gender? How is it different? Now, these are some ladies who have already taken up the roles of men. These are some example, two of them, which you could see. The next one, please. Next. So this is the basic difference what we have to understand. And this is for the students also. So if it's a boy or a girl, when you are going into a class, this is what we have to overlook, that it's a boy or a girl who's standing in front of you. So you're born with biological characteristics. It's universal and not changeable. And gender is learned, socially constructed. It's diverse, culturally different, dynamic and modifiable. So this is in your hand. Next, please. So here again, this we are trying to explain the whole thing with these little lines, and I'm giving you time to read it also, because now you will start connecting with how you're behaving with other people and how in a society or in a group a person is put across the tasks. So these are little things. If you're clear in these definitions, I can assure you that you will never be gender biased. Next, please. So here, so in a nutshell, male, female, born this way and is nature, masculine, feminine, socialized and nurture. So this is the chart which is so beautifully explaining the difference. Next, please. So socialization is, we are all social beings, and this is the process by which boys and girls are trained to fit in a given society values. So you see how important society is. Relationships between men and women are acquired through the process of socialization again. So we have to be very, very aware and alert of what is happening in our society as well. When we are talking about gender sensitivity and we are talking about gender bias and we are talking about all these kind of terms, we got to be also understanding that how well we understand the role of socialization, the role of society, and the role of places where the people are going through and how it is going to be affecting their psyche. Next, please. So sources of socialization, you're partying together, you're going out together, you're going for a movie together, going to school together. So these are all the sources where we are picking up the gender values. Next, please. And it goes stuck here in the brain. Whatever's drilled here, ladki khana banati hai, ladka cart chalata hai. So it's going like that, drill, drill, drill from the society, from the people, from the surroundings. And it gets stuck here and that's how we start behaving. Next, please. And these are the set norms which we think are befitting a female and a masculine. So this is gender bias arising from the base like this. Because we've already got it sorted out here that this is the way it should be. And it is. Next, please. Next, please. So increasing attention is to be given to the importance of in achieving gender equality in education. So we can understand from here how important it is for all of you now and how important it is for you to be sensitive and also to be aware of your role as a teacher. Next, please. So this is very basic. Gender bias, we understand. Next, please. So these are mindset. If you go to the remote areas, what is happening? ladke ko padha dete hain, usko kal ko rozi roti kamani hai. ladki ko kyun padhana hai, wo paraye ghar ja rahi hai. hum us par paisa kyun kharche? wo ghar mein madad karegi. So these are little things, you know, which are right from the roots, they are developing. So when we're talking about gender bias and gender equality and gender awareness at the level that we are now, we've missed the previous part. That is a bridge we have to still cover. Go back, pick those guys up, come to this level. Next, please. So this is the attitude we have towards girl education. And it is so sad. Whereas women are known for multitasking and men do one thing at a time, women are achieving so much in all directions, we are not giving them a chance because of gender bias. Next, please. So unequal access to education, literacy, schooling, violence against women, disabled girls, school availability are little areas which we have to now start deliberating on point to point. Next, please. So this even statistics tells you that the female literacy is lower than the male literacy. And then compared to boys, fewer girls are enrolled. Even health, the boys are looked after more than the health of the girls. So we see that right, the roots itself, they need to be rerouted and nurtured. Next, please. Gender concerns in education, that is our main focus today for the students who are going to be rolling out as teachers. Please, next. These are the various areas. Sir, can we do the previous, please? Okay, I think it's overlapping probably. Please go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. So the cultural previous, please. So these are the areas through which the gender bias can be removed, gender equality can be achieved. And look at this, there's so many of them and they're all connected with us. Attitudes, belief, language, custom, rituals, behavior, faith, religion, food, art, drama, music, and back to attitude. So the basic, I would say, is the attitude. And connected to them are all the others, like a flower. And each one of them is a source of which we can take in to remove the gender bias, to get gender equality. Next, please. We'll see as we go ahead how we can do that. Now, cultural issues in education, they are the conflicts that are misinterpreted that take place in the classroom. Culture is a broad, comprehensive concept that includes all the way of being. All the components could include values, behavior, language, dialects, non-verbal communication, etc., etc. All come into culture. Next, please. So, individual groups and surroundings are always changing. Every culture subgroup may form. Subgroups can differ by any of the component of the culture, including ethnicity, language, depending on the region they are from. So I cannot say that one culture is, you know, controlling the whole of India. Diverse cultures. So diverse views of looking at it, diverse views of handling it. So it's not a very small thing when we talk about gender sensitivity. It's got very deep meaning, rooted context, which we have to address. Next, please. All students are culturally diverse regardless of their race or socioeconomic system. Next, please. Multicultural and multilingual classrooms. The analysis of cultural issues may benefit teachers as well as learners by raising awareness of the hidden cultural assumptions and biases that they bring to the class. This is so important. When we are talking that they're coming from diverse areas, they're also bringing in their diverse biases. And in a classroom, you have, I put it like this, when you have a basket in a fruit market, it has got all kind of fruits. The banana is different from the pomegranate, and the pomegranate is different from the mango, and it's different from the apple, and so on and so forth. So when you go into a class, you have different children from different diverse backgrounds with different cultural briefings and attitudes and thinking. So you have to be, as a teacher, as a mentor, be alert. So you have to take the particular steps. Please go ahead, sir. We will discuss this later also. So this understanding the role of culture plays in the classroom is essential to effective teaching, learning, and communication interaction in general. Next, please. Previous is jumping. पीछे जाना पड़ेगा सर आपको. Next. So come to this. How are we going to erase the gender bias? सबसे पहले school availability, uniform for everybody. It's very important. So when we are talking at the level at my age, when I'm talking about gender sensitivity, I have missed the previous people who are not even being able to go to school. So if I really want to remove and talk about gender equality, then I got to start from there. Somewhere create an awareness among the masses and the people of my age group that let's start working, that school availability is there for everybody. Next, please. Textbooks are... Now, I don't know how many of you have actually gone through the textbooks of the schools. If you see, there was a drive by CBSE about 8 years back when I was part of the CBSE drive also. We were trying to read and go through the lessons of the CBSE books. And believe me, where we were talking about strength, the word was he. Where we were talking about weakness and sufferings, the word was she. So that is where we started reworking on the CBSE books also, that the he, she has to be with the word which is common to both. So it, they, these kind of words were substituted for he, she. Next, please. So we have to see this. Now, teaching and learning method also, what are we going to get engaged in? Knowledge is not only promotes learning and understanding, but also the overall personality of the child. When you're talking about like when we said talk about crying, the boy is never crying, the girl is crying. Isn't it gender bias? So what is my class learning? That if I cry, I become a girl. The book also says the same. So we, our sensitivity has to come to the grassroots level. So I would also suggest to all the students who are going to become teachers, please, before you take a class, read your chapter. Ensure it's not gender bias, because these books have been written way back 30 years, 40 years, 50 years. And CBSE is really working on it. In fact, they would welcome if you would write a suggestion to them that so-and-so chapter of class so-and-so has been found to be gender bias in this paragraph. Please do that. It's appreciated by CBSE also. And we are trying to, you know, rewrite the books and make the books cleaner. Next, please. Because this harms the psyche and the personality of the children. The hidden curriculum. Now, these are the languages. See, hidden curriculum is what is not written in the book. Use of language. The teacher may be gender biased. Arey, tum to rehne do, tum to kar nahi sakte. Indirectly, I have taught the child ke tum kamzor ho, tum ladki ho, ladke ko karne do. So somewhere we have to change our attitude and our way of talking also. Our body language, our eye contact, the gestures, and addressing physical and emotional conflicts of the students. Very important to remove the gender bias from the education system. Next, please. So here you can see we are promoting healthy relationship between boys and girls. Now, this is also a fact which I will share with you. I won't name the schools, but yes, there are some schools which are only girls' schools. And being a counselor, I've been going to a lot of schools of Jammu. So when the only girl school goes to a class 11th, the child goes to class 11th in a co-ed, the child cannot adjust. And you could see it. In fact, a child passing out from an all-girl school or all-boys school cannot adjust at the graduation level in colleges. So I would advocate to remove the gender bias and to be gender sensitive. When you are talking about a classroom seating arrangement, or you're talking about even the the way they are communicating with each other, or even your attendance, nothing should be gender biased. Let's go to the next one. You will probably see next one, please. Next, please. Providing seating arrangement as per needs, irrespective of their gender or caste or religion. As a teacher, please be sensitive to that. जैसे सब लड़कियां लेफ्ट में बैठ जाए, सब लड़के लेफ्ट राइट में बैठ जाए. अगेन मेड अ बेस. वी आर ऑलरेडी सेग्रीगेटिंग देम. बट इफ राइट फ्रॉम द बिगनिंग वी आर मेकिंग देम सिट द वे दे आर सिटिंग, दे लर्न टू कम्युनिकेट, दे लर्न टू रिस्पेक्ट ईच अदर, दे लर्न टू एडजस्ट एंड अडैप्ट टू ईच अदर. एडोलेसेंट गेट्स कॉन्शियस ऑफ द आइडेंटिटी एट दैट लेवल. बिलो क्लास 4th and 5th, they all are playing together without that difference. So proper interaction of the teachers with the students should be there, so that they are gender sensitive and they respect each other irrespective of the sex they belong to. Next, please. Arrangement of names in the attendance register in alphabetic order irrespective of the gender. This already most of the schools are doing. But then again, it depends from person to person. And we're trying to be, all of us are trying to be aware. Next, please. Ensuring equal participation in school activities. If you're going to clean the driveway of the school, why it should be only the boys go? Why not the girls also? If you're going to have a cooking competition, why only the girls to cook? Why not everybody? So these are little small little things which we have to keep in mind now that we are going as teachers across. Next, please. Ensuring equal opportunities in classroom activities, we've already done. Next, please. Assigning roles to students irrespective of gender. Again and again, I am coming to it because this is where we have to be sensitive. Next, please. Distributing learning materials equally. Again, very important, because I have seen unequal distribution of material. Because it's a girl, she needs a particular kind of material, little less. It's a boy, he has a competitive exam. We are not encouraging the girls for competitive exams, and we're giving him a better material. So these kind of hiccups are there still. Next, please. awareness of health education considering both the gender. Next, please. Awareness of sex education. Next, please. In fact, this word sex has been also abolished, and now it says adolescent education. Sightseeing gender fair examples in classroom. Citing gender fair examples. Next, please. Moral stories for mutual respect. Now, this is so very important in a classroom, because what happens? At home, people are talking, people are seeing or observing. Maybe the parents, maybe the family members with gender bias. They're coming to the school with the same mindset. Women have to be beaten. Women have to be in kitchen. Women don't back chat or don't discuss. They keep quiet. The child has learned everything like that and come to class. And if as a teacher, I'm not gender sensitive, I will encourage the same thing. And as an adult, he's again a misfit in the society. So when we are fighting for women's rights and we are fighting, everything goes down the drain, I'll put it like this, unless everybody is aware of it and everybody is going to be implementing it. So again, like moral stories for mutual respect. When I do that in a class, it goes back to home, where the child may also tell the father, Dad, why are you shouting at now, mom? That's where the gender sensitivity and awareness will trickle down. So we have to now go down also, as we are progressing, ensure that the pocket which is left unattended is also cared for. Next, please. Make the student aware of gender equality. We have done. Next, please. Showing inspirational films and videos in classroom. A must for all the teachers, please. I always advocate that the teachers in the making, we must ensure that we have videos with us. I could have spoken all this. I don't need actually the PowerPoint presentation. Why am I doing it? Because what I'm talking, you're listening, but you will take home only 30%. But when you're reading these PPTs and you're looking at these visuals, you will carry home 70%. This was my reason of giving a presentation, because this is something so generic. I can just cover it. And I wanted to show you the effect of this. Now, if I tell you that what have we talked about gender bias, most of you will be able to recollect the slides. What I have spoken, only 30% you will recollect. So this is a lesson, a learning for the teachers. Whenever you are talking to your students, ensure that you have visuals with you. Whenever you are talking, videos or PPT presentation, you must make it 5 minutes, 10 minutes of it. Rest you speak out. Child will never forget what you have taught. Next, please. Next, please. So here, gender sensitive schools, if you go through this, we are saying equality in everything, empowerment of girls. People have taken it wrong. You know, when we talk about gender sensitivity, we talk about women's rights only. The respect has to be given to both the gender, both the sex, and made aware of their roles in the society, in the culture. And then also give them equal opportunities to participate and encourage everybody to come up at the same platform. No one higher, no one lower. Next, please. Trained educators in, so here I would also add the word train peer educators. That is, amongst the students only, start training educators, peer educators. So friend to friend also, they become sensitive on gender issues and they discuss, so that each group, the teacher level is separate, the students are separate, the parents are separate. Every group in their own subgroups are becoming gender aware. Next, please. So role of school management is also very important, which as a teacher, you can bring it to their notice that we have to have teaching and learning material which is gender sensitive. Or I want to sensitize my community about the importance of girl education. Take boys and girls out in the open. So boys are also advocating, ki ladki ko kyun nahi padhate ho? So the aim is that we have no difference in our mind about the sex of the child who's standing in front of me. It's a male or it's a boy or a girl, immaterial. For us, they are students, one under one umbrella. Next, please. Next, please. Now, where can we find gender bias? Just look at this. It's such a vicious circle. From the books, from the role models, from the classroom environment, from the teacher interaction, from the student to student. Everywhere we can find, there are little pockets where gender bias can be found in a school. So it is just not one term. They have so many subunits. And if I am gender aware, if I am aware that what I have to do, I will catch all the five little pockets in a school and work on it differently. That is why I said peer to peer, peer group formation, peer educators, teacher student, teacher teacher. Curriculum, please read your lessons before you go to class. Because when I did this exercise with CBSE, I found so many books which were gender biased. When the tiger came, the woman was crying and somebody, Ramu or something, was fighting the tiger. Why the woman was not fighting the tiger? I mean, these are just general questions which come to the mind. So the books itself are giving you that feeling that, nahi, nahi, tum kamzor ho. And then when, you know, like they are adolescents and then they are adults, they start fighting for women equal right and everything. What about these pockets, which are still generating more and more people who are in the same platform? So next we go. Next, please. So our boys, these are the questions we have to ask ourselves. Are they encouraged to take the same subjects? Are they encouraged to take the same activities? Are they encouraged to continue the schooling at the equal par? What are the roles they are being given? In depth, as a teacher, as a mentor of students and parents and teachers and management, we teachers have a very important role to play. Next, please. So these are just again slides which are showing you. That is football for all or only for boys? Why are we not giving them a chance and let the girl drop out and say, I don't want to play football? But at least let her go to play. Next, please. So similar duties to male and female. Opportunities to go to chalkboard, address and call on boys and girls equally. Next, please. So don't segregate boys and girls, alag alag baith jao, mix group banao. So people who are shy, get them out, whether it's a girl or a boy. But we have a lot of work to do for women, because we have been in the shell for so long that till date everybody is not feeling equal. I'm using the word feeling equal. Some who are vocal, some who are strong are talking. Rest are still in the shell. And this will only be all right when right from the roots we tackle the small children. And right from there we take them on an equal platform to move ahead in life. Next, please. So seating arrangement we have already talked about. And this is also, I would say, inclusive education. All kind of people there, not just the boy and the girl. Next, please. Attendance register, participation in class. Again, I'm repeating just to make sure that you all don't forget. Next, please. Distributing learning material, we have already talked about. Next, please. Health education, equal. This is again something which is often neglected in terms of for girls. Awareness of health education to both. Next, please. So these are all the things which I had again captured so that you all don't forget. Next, please. And these are gender cards. Now, gender cards are very good energizers and very good activity things. So this is something which you can keep up your sleeve whenever you are interacting with students. And you can look at the different things and give it to the children to deliberate on these issues equally, so that everybody has an equal opportunity to deliberate on them and come out with ideas. Next, please. So these can be used here. for the students. And CBSE is also giving you these gender sensitive cards if you look into onto their website. Next, please. Next, please. So the National Policy for Children 2013, please go through it. As teachers, you should be aware of it. That every child is universal, every child is equal, they are interrelated and interdependent, the rights are. The right of identity, nationality, mental, emotional, cognitive, social and cultural development have to be addressed in totality. So please go through this National Policy for Children 2013. If you really want to be a holistic, good teacher. Next, please. The best, so here again, it's a continuation of the national policy. Next, please. I think with this, we finish it. Thank you very much, sir, for supporting me here. And I hope, okay, friends. So, I know I bombarded you with so many slides and all of you must be saying, oh my God, one after the other, and I have so much of work to do. Actually, we have a lot of work to do. You know, whenever somebody invites me or talking on this topic, you know, we are talking about here and now. We are not going deep. We have a role to play and we have to go deep. Where we are is a platform a lot of people are already working on. But as teachers and mentors, you're going to be touching thousands of children coming from different diverse cultures. And you have the power in your hand because you are gender sensitive. So you can train the people to not to be gender biased. So imagine a class 1 and 2 and 3 child is not gender biased. What a beautiful adult he'll be. Think about it. अभी हम लोग इक्वालिटी पर लड़ रहे हैं, हम लोग नारेबाजी लगा रहे हैं, जेंडर इक्वालिटी पर हम सब कुछ कर रहे हैं, बट टेल मी समथिंग, अगर हम नीचे के बेस को नहीं ठीक करेंगे अब तो क्या करोगे? आज के 10 साल के बाद भी हम अडल्ट ही बात कर रहे होंगे. सो व्हेन यू सेड द स्टूडेंट्स आर गोइंग टू बी कनेक्टेड विद मी, आई स्पेशली मेड दिस स्पेसिफिक टू स्टूडेंट्स डेफिनेटली बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट एवरी स्टूडेंट टू फील responsible that it's your duty now to go to the past, pull out people from there, move on together. So I have already given the PPTs with you. Now you can share it with the students also. Let them give presentations wherever they are and let them give it to the people who have not attended today. It'll be learning for them, gives you confidence, and the basic thing is it'll get imbibed in them. You know, when you present something, it gets into your soul. So it's important. So I would now open this house for questions. Anything you would like to ask me?
Yes, thank you so much, ma'am, for such an inspiring and, you know.
I know it was very heavy today.
Yeah, it was heavy, but it was very, you know, worth listening, worth understanding. Because some of the things we also didn't know, you know, being in the school setup, you know, I was not aware that even the books are gender biased. So
yeah,
this is for the first time, you know, I came to know about it. So thank you so much for sharing your experiences with us. Ma'am, just one question that I have. Like, have you ever been rejected on the basis of your ethnicity and gender? And if yes, how did you overcome it? You know, being a counselor and a psychologist, you have so much of vast experience. So did you ever come across, you know, any kind of gender bias in your field?
See, I will go back to my student days. I will go back there. And just once, I think I was in class 11th when I was had to be taken up as a head girl of the school. And I heard the teacher sitting there on the class in the classroom talking about it, ki ladki kaise head girl ban sakti hai, ladke ko rakhna chahiye, and you know, things like that. And my dad was in the army, he was a brigadier, and I came back home and I shared with my dad, because from all sides I had got a yes, and this conversation among teachers in the staff room was you know, coming in my way of becoming the head girl of my school. And I'm so fortunate that my dad stood by me, and he wrote to the principal that yes, make it a fair competition, and if this girl doesn't win it, then get her off. And we both had to debate, and God was kind and I won it. And the teachers didn't have any say and I became the head girl of my school. That was one. But as a counselor, I'll be honest, I really have not had any kind of a challenge like this, because I think the only challenge was being accepted as a counselor. People said ki hum pagal thodi hain jo counselor ke paas jayenge. So that has been a big challenge in Jammu for me, and I have really worked 20 years fighting that thing that going to a counselor is healthy, and like mental health and physical health is equally important. So please come to a counselor kind of a story. So that kind of a thing has not come. One problem comes, I won't call it gender bias, but yes, transference of emotions. Being a lady, I'm facing more chances. That is my big challenge again. So that is where I have to work on myself as a counselor, where I have to show myself as a neutral. I know this because the patient doesn't know that I am patient takes me as a woman counseling. And transference of emotion is one challenge one can face. Otherwise, playing my role as a counselor, be it be a man or a woman, as long as they are the issues are redressed, I've not faced any challenge. Okay. Any other question?
One more question. After going through your slides, one thing just was looking at. Women are even during COVID times also. Women were working double shifts. In fact, millions of women, all around the world, they are working double shifts, and even in advanced economies also, they were working double shifts and they were paid less. So what do you have to say about that?
It's very unfortunate, because if you look at the statistics and if you look at the graph, a woman is found to be more hardworking. She gets into minor details. I seek pardon from all the gentlemen here, because they are proficient, they are good, but women, there's a difference. If women are from Venus, men are from Mars. There's a beautiful book, you must read that, that shows the difference between the two sex. Now, women can multitask, men do one thing at a time, diligently. Women have a habit or a knack of getting into minute details, which men overlook many a times. Why I would, if it goes to me, I would say that they have been they were born equal in the sense of working on particular issues, but drilled in their mind ke chalta hai, because women have to face a lot of challenges. So somewhere the woman gets into minor details with the fear that at the back of her mind, I don't want to fail. So they go deeper into every small detail. But men will go casual saying chalta hai. So this is something which has to be revisited by both. With this awareness, gender equality, and what we are talking about is coming. Another few years, they will make the men run. Men will also be going into minor details, because the women will be, already you can see in a lot of areas, they're surpassing men. So the casual attitude somewhere has to now get more focused.
Thank you, ma'am. Vita, ma'am, any questions from the students?
Somebody raised a hand, Aditi.
Yes, ma'am, Aditi.
Yes, ma'am. A very good afternoon to all the teachers and all the and ma'am, of course, to you. You have presented your views beautifully, ma'am, and it's touched me so much. I had one query, ma'am. Nowadays, obviously, we have gender bias, but I think some changes are taking place. Like you see the ad of Behru, which shows a woman coming back from work and the man serving the lady the food. So as such, we are noticing a bit of changes taking place. Do you think, as a counselor and such a learned person you are, that for the wheel to strike back, like they say it's a man's world, do we need to have it come to a point of a woman's world, and then the gender equality will strike? Do you think it has to go that way?
Aditi, you're a smart child. How do we progress? We progress when both the wheels are at equal level.
Yes, ma'am.
Today, the men are here, we are here. In the approach.
Yes.
Nothing else, right? We are good. But here. So we are working to it. And now slowly we are surpassing. I will not say we want to make it a women's world. We want to make it our world. where we work together hand in hand. The ad is showing a cup of tea being given by the husband. Only ad is being seen. How many husbands are actually giving tea to women? Mindset has to change, you know. Yes. And all these ads and all these awareness campaigns and everything will get the change slowly and slowly. Definitely, it has to come. Because till we are equal, we as society cannot progress. We cannot, you know, walk on somebody and say, I built a home. No. We have to hold our hands together and we build the home brick by brick. And it starts from home. Mind you, it doesn't start even from the school. It starts from home.
Yes, ma'am.
Mother and father are the ones who are nurturing these thoughts, the beliefs, and the education to the child. Right from there, if a boy respects the sister, the boy respects the wife, boy respects the mother, boy respects, they move like that. The girl will automatically also give it back. So we are moving like this. Moment if this is high or this is high, we can never progress as a society. So let's not make it a women's world. We make it our world where men and women walk together hand in hand.
Right. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, dear.
Any other question, ma'am, or shall we?
I need a question from a male participant. Because I don't want them suffering silently just because we are dominating the screen. और अगर हमने कहीं गलत बोला है तो जरूर men can raise their hand and say आपने ये चीज गलत बोल दी. No problems. I'm open to it. Yeah. Any other questions?
Rita, ma'am, any other questions? Shall we move forward?
Ma'am, there is one question. Is gender equality a concern for men only?
No. Gender equality is a concern for both. Yes. For both. Just because, if men are feeling threatened because the women are asking for their rights or they are trying to come at their level, that's something wrong. Because a woman is fighting for her rights. Why should she fight for the rights? We are partners in the society. We are partners at home. We are partners everywhere. So why should any group, whether it's a boy or a girl, a male or a female group, why should they fight for their rights? Rights should be automatically given at par with each other. Why not? And that's how we progress. If you remember one slide which said, in the class, teach them to respect each other. If a boy and a girl respect each other, where is the question of fighting for the rights?
Yes.
So this is something we have to really deliberate on and go deep into it. You will find a lot of women activists, you know, really saying, "Nare lagao, jeet jao, hum ye hai, hum wo hai." I don't agree. Because I feel a society can be progressive only when both the wheels are at par with each other. And for that, we have to respect each other and let everybody be at equal level.
Right, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Even feminism movement was started not only by women, but the male were also in support. When some of the scholars and professors in US, they found the discrimination towards women, discrimination and humiliation, and you can say there was suppression also towards the female. And then they raised their voice, and definitely it was expanded to other part of the world also.
Very right.
So yes,
you're absolutely right. Yes. But you know what happens in the whole world? It was just a group of men who work. कहते ज़मीर उठा उनका.
Yes.
इतने से का.
All right. So, ma'am, shall we move forward because we have to listen to
ma'am. Sonali.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, continue.
Thank you, ma'am, for enlightening us all with your inspiring and motivational thoughts and experiences. Now, I request our worthy chairperson, Dr. Renu Gupta, ma'am, flag bearer of women empowerment and leadership, to share her valuable thoughts with us.
So good afternoon, all of you. I hope Chantrehan ma'am is there.
उनका थोड़ा सा वो रुका हुआ है शायद, I don't know, it's probably frozen her this thing. Is she?
Can you ask ma'am? Yeah, now.
नहीं.
Yes, ma'am. Can you get in touch?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I think she has left.
Let me.
May I call her?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you.
She thought it might be over or something.
वीडियो वो हो गया था एक्चुअली.
हाँ वीडियो.
बोल रहा सर मुझे लगा आप मेन के बिहाफ पे क्वेश्चंस पूछेंगे स्टूडेंट और मेन के बिहाफ पे.
नहीं पर मेन शुड कम आउट बिकॉज़ यस दे शुड नॉट बी. मूलराज जी आपको क्वेश्चन पूछने थे आपको ढूंढ रहे थे.
नहीं नहीं आई वाज देयर मैम बट ये था कि मोस्टली उन्होंने एक्सप्लेन कर दिया है और जो भी चीजें थी वो ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि बिकॉज़ कुछ चीजें आंसर्ड हैं तो इसलिए That's why. Otherwise, तो
आंसर होते हैं तो कुछ क्वेश्चन और निकल के आते हैं ना. Continuous process.
At the moment I was supposed to, you can say, start the question. So उस टाइम फिर next shift हो गया. Otherwise, there was a question. Yeah. And because mostly मतलब यही होता है कि नहीं men are held responsible for the this gender inequality and so. But I want to know that. How many studies are there which shows about this, and if we want to, you can say, have a percentage that how men are, how many men are responsible for this condition, and how many women are responsible for this condition. So that is a debatable thing, and research are happening in those. Because usually, हम एक proverb सुनते हैं कि नहीं औरत ही औरत की दुश्मन होती है, तो that's why these are the things जो कि बहुत एक हैं चीजें exist करती हैं हमारी society में भी हैं ये prevail करती हैं. But as our student has said that the scenarios are changing, and yes, those are changing, and those are changing rapidly. I think if you see, agar hamare hi aap staff mein dekh le ya students mein dekh le, so there are many examples ki equally contribute kar rahe hain men and women. Aisa to, so that's what you can say.
So we are at a stage, we are at a mature stage. We've understood, and we may have changed our attitudes and behavior, but. This is probably meant for our would-be teachers, our young people who are going to enter the world of work, where they will start seeing discrimination happening. Phir us samay agar if they are trained, their mind is trained, so they can probably look for these angularities and you know bring about a change not only in themselves but also with the students and youngsters.
Yeah, and when moreover, if we see at the school level, then things are totally changed. I'm not saying that changing, but they are changed now because student ka agar dekhiye male female mein wahan gender biasness bilkul nahi hai. Student behave like you can say they are girls or boys. So now she has joined, so you can start, ma'am. Thank
you. So maybe I was happy. So you were talking. I was happy. I was asking somebody to. I'm happy to hear.
मैंने कहा आप थोड़ा disconnect हो गए तो मैंने कहा male member हमारे तो we were having a conversation. So probably you missed out on it.
I was happy, ma'am. So, but I said कि हम इतना heavy slides नहीं आके सारे मेल चुप करके बैठ गए. मेरे को कुछ तो बोलो.
मेल बेचारे वैसे ही कम होते हैं तो वो बेचारे कहते हैं कि ठीक है आप ठीक ही हो. But I think I would like to say something. I just you know given a chance, I'll take just 5 minutes because probably.
No, ma'am. No.
So basically what I'm trying to say is that gender inequalities, what it really means is when men and women, boys and girls are not treated equal. I mean, it's a simple statement. And, you know, reflecting on your presentation, I said that gender inequality is a social reconstruct created by the society. We are born equal. Nobody is saying that you are different. But of course, apart from being biological differences, they are very obvious also. And I don't think we need to do much about them. As I always, as a woman, I say that if you are a woman, you must celebrate your womanhood. you know, you and enjoy, you are different, but we have so many, you know, advantages like body. You said ki usme hum better hain because we take good care of ourselves being women, so probably, you know, and I think we should be proud of women and we should celebrate it being women, nothing to feel complex about. And as I said, it's a social reconstruct, so it starts from home, the time we are born. Because जैसे आप examples दे रहे थे कि मेरे को toy दिया truck वाला और brother को और उसको, तो you know we always say blue for boys and pink for girls. So pink dresses लेते हैं, अभी लड़की हुई है तो pink ही लेनी, why not blue to the boy and to, so it starts from the time we are born and then it is always a he for hearth and she for the home. So you know it keeps on adding and I think we get defined and I think we are just forced into these roles just by dint of being a boy or a girl. And as we grow as adults, so gender inequality between men and you know women, they, it starts creating a gap, big gap, with the result that women start getting discriminated against and they suffer all kinds of injustice in their lives, because it may be in the school, society, wherever, because of that social construct. Of course, I think part of it, I would also like to, you know, give our society, our elders, because being a woman, probably we wanted to be protected, or we wanted to protect our body for being misused by men. And, you know, we have the consequences of when we get, you know, misused, abused for our body. So probably that was just to protect girls so that they cannot go. Probably that would be one reason why it started by this thing, but then it went into too long a thing. So probably I think that was the only injustice we had to face. So of course now we are becoming bold, but still, even if we talk of any women going alone at this time, I think most of us, even we may be very strong, we'll be very scared because physically we may not be able to defend ourselves. So this one is quite a, this thing in our mind. So we have to take care of that. Then I would say, the on the contrary, what is gender equality? It means getting equal fair treatment of men and women irrespective of their gender. So basis of equality is meritocracy, capability, talent, abilities of either sex. So that would be a real gender equality. Ki hum kuch bhi hai, hamari meritocracy hai, par aage jaise aapne kaha ki you as a head girl, so your you know father wrote to them ki ha equal hai merit, if she wins and you won, even that long time back. So that is what was gender equality. And your you know father was so sensitive to it, and he was, I think, very, I would say, wise person even at that time. And when we say gender equality, how is it possible? It's only possible through gender equity. You know, there is another word which is different from equality. Equity, जैसे आप कह रहे थे हम यहाँ पे हैं, तो हम यहाँ हैं, आदमी यहाँ हैं, तो यहाँ पे आएंगे हम तो तभी equity होगी, अब हमको बराबर दिया गया. We don't want to go here. I would also back to, why should we go? Of course, we've already gone here. So we are in fact giving, you know, becoming more aggressive and threatening men. Literally, I'm saying, because when we see here and now, मुझे लगता है कि girls have become more aggressive, और आदमियों को they are difficult to control, even in social relationships, even in married lives, the girls have become so aggressive कि boys की बार कहते हैं मैं तो शादी नहीं करानी, I won't be able to handle her, because they are coming with all their rights and this thing. So this is also a contrast which I didn't want to touch. So we have to, you know, avoid these, because I find boys more submissive. Girls are working in this thing, MNC, so unke bhai, you know, it's happening around, because you can also see if I give you examples. So extreme nahi hai, parity deni hai, hum barabar layenge, paye de denge, dono barabar chalo. But equity, tab unko laya, aur uske baad equal opportunities to be given, you know, to men and women, they can help at being at par with men. और उसके बाद कंपीट करिए इन ऑल वॉक्स ऑफ लाइफ, एंड बस जो भी है, नो डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. ऑफ कोर्स माइंडसेट हैज टू बी चेंज्ड. जैसे आप सिलेक्शन कमेटी में जाते हैं तो ऑब्वियसली मेन विल, यू नो, देयर आर जेंडर बायस्ड इंटरव्यूज आल्सो, बिकॉज मेन को तो कहेंगे हाँ जी आप तो कल से ही ज्वाइन करेंगे, मैडम आप कैसे ज्वाइन करेंगे, आपका बच्चा छोटा है, आप उसको कहाँ रखेंगे, कोई फैमिली सपोर्ट है, तो उसको तो वैसे ही मॉरल डाउन हो जाता है कि ठीक है मेरे को तो इसको मिल जानी जॉब, मेरे को तो और प्रॉब्लम है। वो इफ़ यू शेयर योर प्रॉब्लम देल से कि मैडम अच्छा चलो अभी हम इनको रख लेते हैं, सो यू नो ऑल दोस थिंग्स आर देयर, बट वी फॉर दिस आई थिंक वी नीड टू हैव जेंडर फ्रेंडली पॉलिसीज स्पेशली फॉर वीमेन इफ वी वॉन्ट टू ब्रिंग दैम एट पार। और फिर कोई इनिशिएटिव्स भी लेने पड़ेंगे जेंडर पॉजिटिव इनिशिएटिव्स की, अगर मान लो वी आर द चाइल्ड बेयरिंग यू नो एंड फैमिली यू नो टेकिंग केयर पर्संस, सो उसके लिए हमें क्या आप जेंडर पॉजिटिव इनिशिएटिव्स दोगे, बच्चों को कहीं रखेंगे, क्रैश रखेंगे, हाउ इफ यू वांट टू वर्क हाउ विल यू नो, कितनी एड्स होती हैं कि व्हेन यू आर प्रेग्नेंट तो वो एक आपको सेपरेट कैबिन दे दिया आपके बॉस ने, सो शी इज सेइंग मेरे को पता नहीं क्या होगा, so the boss is saying okay you are going to, so she feels so happy, so just a gender positive initiative of an organization who is having a male boss but he is sensitive to that. aur chote chote mujhe examples yaad aa rahe hain, jaise ek ad aati hai ki rural area mein doodh do maa doodh ke glass lati hai bacche ko, ladke ko bada hai doodh diya hua hai ladki ko itna sa, so the boy looks at the mother and looks at his glass and sees the glass of her. And what he does is he pours his glass and make it equal. So, you know, these are so many things awareness ho rahi hai. But provided, you know, if we start making our students and would-be teachers become aware, so they will become gender sensitive. So this way we can, actually the main aim is to create a gender neutral society. Jahan hame औरत आदमी नहीं दिख रहे हैं, हमें इंडिविजुअल्स दिख रहे हैं, हमें ह्यूमन बीइंग्स दिखते हैं कि हाँ ये ह्यूमन बीइंग्स है, ये इंडिविजुअल है, फिर थर्ड हमारा कॉन्सेप्ट आना चाहिए कि हाँ ये औरत है कि आदमी है, सो दैट इज प्रॉब्ली वी विल बी हेडिंग, सो इट इज ओनली द इंडिविजुअल क्रेडेंशियल्स विच शुड मैटर रादर देन द जेंडर। और बाकी जैसे आपने कहा रोल ऑफ टीचर्स, आपने इतना इलेबोरेट बताया सब कुछ है, मैं तो सिर्फ यही बोलूंगी कि सिंस our would be teachers are interacting and also our teacher educators are interacting and they have attended such a illuminating session by you who is not even a psychologist but a psychiatrist and an experienced certified you know counselor for CBSE RCI ki to Ronika ma'am hai hamare jo B.Ed special ke, so even I will request you to call her for another session in the B.Ed special education department,
sure,
so, we can learn so much from her, so probably I think the takeaway is that we must become gender sensitive,
yeah,
jo inhone kaha, aur phir uske baad kya ki hame favoritism nahi karna hai ki ye boy hai to usko kar diya, haan ji ye boy hai, jaise ye keh rahe hain ki nahi abhi aapko nahi aata boy kar lega, aur wahi jaise aap keh rahe hain ki hum main school mein gayi jahan girls thi to hame bhi, if you were attending some CBSE you know workshops, I have been attending that capacity building workshops. आप लोगों ने हमारे साथ कईयों ने की हुई है, तो gender books हमें भी कहा गया था कि इसमें निकालो genderized क्या है, ये वहाँ girl वो औरत थी वो रोती पाई गई तो आदमी ये हो गया वो active हो गया, you know we think that in a fearful situation we are going to be you know frozen and men will be very active, it can be anything,
yeah,
these are some of the things, so we have to encourage the girls to you know overcome their complexities because we go in that complex mode ki nahi hamara aisa hai hum ye nahi kar sakte hamari body hai aur hamara wo hai, we have to go through so many processes which are different from men, so I think wo we have not only to you know have allow our personal biases to come in the way of you know our growth and development, or as far as schools are concerned aapne bahut acha bataya ki they also play an important role in you know both the genders and we have to provide equal opportunities, equal participation, and so many times we've heard ki girls ne ji wo zyada topper hain, zyada acha padha rahi hain, pad rahi hain, unki results are also good, so for both the boys and of course you've talked much, but I would also like to you know talk about the head of the institution who should be very sensitive, aur agar गर्ल्स के हैं तो कई बार परेड कॉलेज में यू नो आई यूज्ड टू ऑलवेज इंटरेक्ट उनके विमेन स्टडीज है हम उनके पास भी जाते थे, सो दिस टाइम द ऑल द यू नो विमेन वर कंप्लेनिंग इन परेड कॉलेज दैट वी हैव अ मेल प्रिंसिपल, मैडम देखो सारा गर्ल्स कॉलेज है और मेल प्रिंसिपल रख दिया हुआ है, और दूसरा जैसे ऑफ कोर्स दिस इज अवे फ्रॉम द रिकॉर्ड, बीएड कॉलेज में हमारे प्रिंसिपल होते हैं जिन्होंने खुद बीएड नहीं की हुई, तो वो कहते हैं मैडम देखो ये हमें क्या गाइड करेंगे बीएड कॉलेज में जब टीचिंग प्रैक्टिस, जब उन्होंने मैडम बीएड नहीं किया उनको क्यों बनाया प्रिंसिपल, तो ये गवर्नमेंट के तो मैडम ऐसे हैं. सो मतलब वी पुट रॉन्ग पीपल इन द रॉन्ग प्लेसेस. सो प्रोबब्ली द हेड ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूशन शुड बी वेरी सेंसिटिव टू दीज इश्यूज. तो वो चीजें हैं कि स्कूल में तो मैं यही कहूंगी, और बाकी देखो सोसाइटी भी जो है, society is the creator and initiator of process of genderization, जैसे हमने बोला कि बचपन से ही वो करते हैं हमें, but the parents have to play a very important role, because जब भी हम sharing of experiences करते हैं, then we are also asking you questions, जैसे रूपा जी ने आपको personal questions किए, तो sharing of experiences में भी हम कहते हैं कि आप बताइए कि आपको कोई discrimination हुई, और जब हुई तो who were your support systems. So we find that so many times women always take the names of their fathers, their brothers and male members that they supported them, and that's how they were shaped differently. So matlab ye hai ki men may be silent but they are basically supporters, and we can't do without them. Hum jahan pe hain agar koi hame aware kiya, kisi ne hame karne diya hai capacity building ka program, किसी ने जैसे आई हैड गॉन वंस अलोन विद यू नो टू यूएस फॉर वन मंथ, सो माय आपके चेयरपर्सन के फ्रेंड सारे बोलने लगे ओहो आप अपनी बीवी को अकेले भेज रहे हो वो भी यूएस, तो ये नहीं पता उन्होंने कहा भैया वो अकेली नहीं जा रही हैं, देर आर 20 पीपल इन हर ग्रुप एंड दे आर फ्रॉम डिफरेंट कंट्रीज. तो मतलब ही हैड फेथ इन मी, दैट्स वाई एंड आई केम बैक एज अ यू नो टोटली चेंज पर्सन. So I think men always support, but ये ठीक कहते हैं कि men are looking always at the larger picture, और हम छोटी छोटी चीजों से करते हैं, हम नीचे से छोटी चीजें करते हैं आदमी ऊपर से, so somewhere we meet in the center and we make a good, you know, this thing के women take care of smaller things, men take care of big things, that's how the society works. So we are equal partners. If we are 50% of the population, that means men are also 50%. और बाकी तो मैं कह रही हूँ जेंडर बेंडर है एक वर्ड, जो जेंडर बायस भी आ गया, जेंडर सेंसिटिविटी भी है, तो जेंडर बेंडर है कि विमेन आर बेंडिंग द जेंडर बाय गोइंग टू मेल बेस्टियंस, कोई आज पायलट बन रही हैं, कोई कुछ बन रही हैं जहाँ वी नेवर थॉट ऑफ गोइंग. So that is also, that is very creditable. So they are, we are not challenging men, but we are becoming equal partners. Ke wahan bhi agar hum unka saath de sakte hain, we can make history with them. So I think that would be the best thing. That would be an ideal, you know, example of gender equality. That's what I would like to say. And I would like to thank Dr. Trehan for, you know, being with us and, you know, telling us all about, you know, the gender equality and all the biases, but let's not only look at the problems, let's only find out okay, the problems abhi bhi ye ho rahi hain aur kuch jo nahi ho chuki hai unko move forward. 2-3 agar hamara institution ya hamara college leta hai ki ha bhai ye do biases hain isko hum khud karenge in the context of organizational लेडीज को प्रेफरेंस मिलनी चाहिए, दे शुड बी पार्ट ऑफ ऑल कमेटीज. ये तो यूजीसी भी कहता है कि आप मेन की कमेटी रखनी है, उसमें विमेन रिप्रेजेंटेटिव होनी चाहिए, 2/3 मेजोरिटी होनी चाहिए उनकी, सो दैट दे हैव अ से इन द डिसीजन मेकिंग. खुद तो खुद वो आई थिंक दे विल थिंक के वी आर इक्वल मेंबर्स एंड वी मस्ट कंट्रीब्यूट टुगेदर इन द सोसाइटी. सो थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू मैम, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर शेयरिंग योर एक्सपीरियंसेस विद अस.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your words of wisdom and inspiration. Now, I would request Mrs. Arpana Kohl, Assistant Professor, my College of Education, to propose the formal vote of thanks.
Thank you, Sonali. Good afternoon, everyone. It has been rightly said, no duty is more urgent than that of returning thanks. So I'm delighted to have been given the pleasant duty of delivering the vote of thanks this afternoon. On behalf of Meyer College of Education, I would like to thank Dr. Renu Gupta, worthy chairperson, Meyer Group of Institutions, for gracing the occasion and sharing her valuable thoughts with us. With great pleasure, I would like to express on the behalf of the college a deep appreciation to the resource person of today's session, Dr. Chan Trihan, Registered Counselor, RCI, Rehabilitation Council of India, for sharing her knowledge and experiences with us. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable inputs and enlightening us all on gender inequalities. This event is a collaborative effort, a joint venture of all the stakeholders. We are highly appreciative of the leadership, encouragement, and extensive support provided by Dr. Adit Gupta, Director and Principal, Meyer College, Mrs. Rupa Gupta, Joint Director, Meyer, Dr. Moolraj Sharma, HOD PG Department, and Dr. Ronika Sharma, HOD UG Department, for their continuous support and guidance. I'm grateful to Dr. Nishtha Rana and Dr. Monica Bajaj, Deputy HODs, PG and UG Department, for their timely support and significant contribution. I express my gratitude to all the faculty members and students of Meyer College for attending the event. I extend my sincere thanks to Dr. Rita Divedi, Assistant Professor, Meyer College, for organizing this event in a benefiting manner. Last but not the least, this event would not have been possible without the technological support provided by Mr. Rajan Salathya. Thank you so much, sir. Once again, I thank you, everyone. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Arpana. And to the team, because without them,